like to stand and sing together our national anthem, O Canada. We'll give you a few bars to get your patience.
Thank you.
Okay. How many did you count? 35. Excellent. How many did you count? 35 hands up. That's fantastic. Okay, now, orchestras are made up of four different families. Did you learn that at school?
Yeah.
Okay. Can somebody tell me the name of one of the families?
Would that be okay?
Brass, right? Yes. And another one of the families. Strings, yes. And another one of the families. Say it. Percussion, right. So we have strings, brass, and percussion. What have we got left? Yes. Woodwinds, that's right. We're going to start with the woodwinds, and we're going to hear each of the different voices, because every different instrument has a different kind of sound if you're speaking a different type of language. So we're starting with the flute. And then we have the oboe. One sounds very windy, sort of like floating across a Coke bottle, and the other one sounds like it might have a call to the oboe, of course. It produces its sound by taking two pieces of reed, putting it together, and like. Can you all do that with me? That's right. And we have clarinets. Sound with one reed vibrating across against the mouthpiece. And then we have an instrument that looks like a weapon of mass destruction. It's called the bassoon. And the bassoon is the cousin of the oboe because it produces sound with two reeds, as we did before, going together. Right. Okay. Now we'll visit with the brass section, starting with the trumpet. Now, all brass instruments create their sound by buzzing into a mouthpiece. You all do this with me together. That's right. And if you would then put a mouthpiece on it, the sound would be very clear and you'd actually get a note. Did you want to try with that just to show them, perhaps? That's just the mouthpiece, and you add the trumpet. Fabulous. So next we have the French horns. I like the French horn sound, don't you? And then we got the trombones. Two different parts of the percussion family. First, the one that produces sound effects, like a snare drum, a cymbal, and a
bass drop, like this. And then over here we have a set of timpani. They can actually play in tune. Paul, do you want to wave at them, wave at the kids? Paul trained all these people at high school to come and join the National Academy Orchestra today. Let's have a round of applause for all these great kids. Okay, so we'll excuse them now. They can go back and enjoy the rest of the concert because we're about to tell a story. Now, the author of this story, Lisa Suhai, made up this story for her children to teach them about peace and love. Now, please help me welcome Lexis Chenevay, a drama student from Glendale Academy, to help us tell the story. Lexis.
underground army. Then, the army of shadow began to strike without warning, bringing fear, sadness, and hate to innocent creatures.
Are many. How can I ever hope to succeed?
you will know that as the shadow began with one small dark being, now the light will grow with you, my small messenger.
Mary Tabone and the BR Junior Xpression Choir play probably one of the most famous popular songs called Imagine. It's a song that was co-written by a Beatle, John Lennon, and his wife, Yoko Ono. Now, it was the best-selling single of his solo career. In its lyrics, he tells us to imagine a world at peace, with no barriers or borders or divisions of race, nationality, and to consider the possibility that the whole of humanity would live unattached to things. And I think that's something that's important to remember when you're going out and buying a cell phone. Okay? Here we go.
It's easy if you try. You are peace.
turn to come and help us sing with the orchestra and the BR Junior Xpression Choir. You'll see some words, and I'm sure you'll recognize the melody, though you're not drinking any coke. Conductor, exactly. Now, I'd like to choose somebody to come up and conduct our orchestra. Who would like to do that? Let's see, who would like to do that? Would you like to do that? Yeah, come on up. Number, that's it. There we go. Come to the end of that row, and we'll help you get on stage. Great, come on over here. Okay, well, I've got this music stand in the way, and I can't move it, so you'll have to sort of conduct above it, okay? You think you can do that? I don't know, I guess so. All right, now, turn around to the audience here. Come on over here, because there's another stand in your way. I'm going to give you a quick conductor lesson. This goes for everybody. Help me here. You know, you've seen conductors in front of an orchestra going, what are they doing? Moving their arms around, and nobody seems to be watching. Well, they do watch, the musicians watch, and they will follow us. And one of the first lessons we learn is how to breathe with the orchestra. So I'm going to ask you to breathe on my upbeat. What's your name, by the way? Emma. Okay, Emma, I'm going to ask you to help us breathe together, and then we're going to come together down at a point right in the middle of our belly button, and that's where the orchestra's going to play. Ready? Breathe, play. All of you together? I didn't hear you. Good. Okay, now this piece is in two. Okay, it goes like this. One, two, one, two, one, two. One is down here, and two is up here. Okay? Now, the most important lesson in conducting is keep your arms moving until the orchestra stops, then turn around and bow. Remember that? Okay, Emma. Here's the National Academy Orchestra. Emma, come on over here. I'll help you get started. Okay? Are you ready? Here we go. You can read the score over here. I have it over here for you. Okay? Here we go.
Every heart, a child's every
Travis from Glendale School of the Arts, our silk artists and our narrator and the members of the orchestra who performed, and particularly their teacher, Paul Boris, who helped us put all of this together. I'd also like to thank the members of the BR Junior Xpression Choir and their conductor, Mary Tabone and Dave Tabone on the piano, and the members of the National Academy Orchestra. Would you like to stand up and take a bow, please? And my assistant, Christina, I know this is Dr. Christina, would everyone take a bow? I'd like to thank you all for being such a wonderful audience and engaged. Did you have fun? So come back and see us again soon. Okay, I don't want you to leave just yet. The orchestra and artists are going to leave the stage, but please stay in your seats and a penny from Hamilton Place, otherwise, owe you a penny. Christina is going to help dismiss you. Okay, thanks again for being a great audience, and thanks to all our wonderful artists. Bye.